Photo sharing app Instagram calls for the creation of an industry body to help keep young people safe online. In a testimony before US lawmakers, Instagram CEO Adam Mosseri said the body should create standards on how to verify age, design age-appropriate experiences, and build parental controls for young users. Instagram and its parent company Meta Platforms have come under intense scrutiny over the potential impact of their services on the mental health and online safety of young users. Instagram earlier suspended plans for a version of the app for kids amid growing opposition to the project.
The body should receive input from civil society, from parents, and from regulators. The standards need to be high, and the protections universal. And we've been calling for regulation for nearly 3 years now. On age verification, we're developing new technologies to address this industry-wide challenge. We're creating a menu of options to allow people to verify that they're old enough to use Instagram, that extend beyond simply relying on an ID card. And we're building new technology to proactively find and remove accounts belonging to those under the age of 13.
A military helicopter crashes in India, killing 13 people, including the country's armed forces chief and his wife. The cause of the crash is still unknown. The chopper was on its way to a military college when it went down. Only one survived. Prime Minister Narendra Modi expressed his grief on Twitter. He also hailed his top military general, whom he appointed in 2019 as India's first chief of defense staff, to integrate the country's army, navy, and air force services.
Germany marks the start of a new era as Chancellor Angela Merkel hands over power to Social Democrat Olaf Scholz. This ends Merkel's 16-year conservative rule and paves the way for the coalition government of Scholz, which has promised to boost green investment and strengthen European unity. Scholz is Germany's ninth chancellor since the end of World War II.
The U.S. and Russia set for another meeting this week amid a potential Kremlin invasion in Ukraine. Russian President Vladimir Putin says he will send their reply to Washington within a week to follow up with his Tuesday video call with U.S. President Joe Biden. Biden had warned of sanctions should Russia invade Ukraine. That's after a Russian military buildup near Kiev. Putin, meanwhile, demanded guarantees that NATO would not expand further eastward.
We hope by Friday we're going to be able to say and announce to you that we're having meetings at a higher level, not just with us, but with at least four of our major NATO allies and Russia to discuss the future of Russia's concerns relative to NATO writ large and whether or not we can work out any accommodations as it relates to bringing down the temperature along the Eastern Front.
Canada joins its ally countries in holding a diplomatic boycott of the upcoming Beijing Winter Olympics. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau announced the move Wednesday as he called out China over its supposed human rights violations. Like Canada, the U.S., Australia, and Britain will not be sending diplomatic representatives when the Games kick off in February.
As many partners around the world, we are extremely concerned by the repeated human rights violations by the Chinese government. That is why we are announcing today that we will not be sending any diplomatic representation to the Beijing Olympic Paralympic Games this winter.
Meanwhile, the president of the International Olympic Committee explained the body's silence on the issue, saying the body is against politicizing the event.
By not commenting on political issues, you're not taking a side, neither the one nor the other. And this is, the mission of the IOC. Otherwise, we could not manage to accomplish the mission there of the Games to bring and to unite the world. If we would start to take political sides on one way or the other,